Hey there, it's Mrs. Shaner. Today we're going to talk about the importance of protein and the importance of play. Every cell in the human body has protein. Proteins are the building blocks that make up our bodies. If you think of your body as a building, proteins would be the framework, the bones, muscles, tendons, and ligaments, which make up the framework of our bodies, all need protein to remain strong. The body uses protein to repair and replace worn out parts. Growing children need protein daily to grow and develop. Protein steadies the blood sugar so you don't get the high and low filling that happens after eating sugary foods. Protein creates a full and satisfied filling. The eating and digesting of protein burns more calories than consuming the same amount of carbs. Protein acts as a natural antidepressant. It helps improve behavior and mood. Protein is necessary for proper growth and development. Children need about 1 gram of protein per pound of body weight per day because your body is growing at a more rapid pace than adults. Adults need at least 0.5 gram per pound of body weight per day. You can always look at food labels to see how much protein you're eating. As a general rule, if you're eating a balanced diet of whole foods, there is no need to keep track of the grams. It's not too difficult to get enough protein if you are making good food choices throughout your day, like I'm showing here. 1 cup of oatmeal equals 6 grams of protein. 1 cup of milk equals 8 grams of protein. 1 cup of whole wheat pasta equals 7 grams of protein. 1 tablespoon of peanut butter equals 4 grams of protein. 2 ounces of chicken breast equals 13 grams of protein. Most proteins are found in yellow light foods, but some green light foods also contain protein. Just like carbohydrates, you can judge a protein by the company it keeps. Red light foods such as fried chicken, sausage meats, or ice cream contain many unhealthy ingredients like unhealthy fats or sugar. And even though they do have some protein, they're not the greatest source of protein. Foods that have the most powerful protein are often lean proteins. Lean proteins are generally lower in fat and high in nutrients. There are many green and yellow light foods that are high in protein, including fish, grilled, baked, or broiled is best, chicken, without the skin is best, eggs, lean meat, also grilled, baked, or broiled, nuts and seeds. 1 ounce of almonds gives about 6 grams of protein. Whole grains, 1 slice of whole wheat bread gives about 3 grams of protein. Legumes like beans, lentils, and peas. Also dairy products, cottage cheese, Greek yogurt, and milk. Choose organic when possible. Also vegetables such as artichokes, spinach, and kale are great protein sources. You can get a lot of your daily protein and calories from snacks between meals. So it's important to make sure your snacks are rich with protein and nutrient dense, which means they're packed with nutrition rather than calories. Snacks should be tasty, but not leave you feeling so full the way a big meal does. Healthy snacks include foods that are high in protein, fiber, complex carbs, and small amounts of healthy fat. Here are some suggestions for mid-morning or mid-afternoon snacks. Yogurt. Plain Greek yogurt is best, topped with sliced almonds and fruit and small amount of honey. Carrot and celery sticks or cherry tomatoes dipped in hummus. Cut up apples, pears, bananas, and other fresh fruit with peanut butter. Hard-boiled eggs. They're a great source of protein and healthy fat. Keep a few in your fridge. Peanut butter on whole grain wheat crackers or bread. Cheese slices on whole grain wheat crackers. Air pop popcorn. Garbanzo beans. You can roast them up for a crunchy, salty snack. And nuts. Eat no more than 1 palmful for a snack. As we've learned, proper nutrition is so important for overall health and development. Exercise is just as important. If you don't make these habits as kids, it's most likely you won't make them as adults either. The early years are a very important time to help kids learn how to be healthy and be active. Once upon a time, kids ran for entertainment. Now they sit more often. Kids are naturally active and should spend a lot of time running and playing. Most parents worry more about their kids learning to sit still than if they are getting enough exercise. But the fact is, many kids are overweight because they do not get enough exercise. They sit around watching television instead of running around outside. As with other good habits, moving around and being active is one habit kids can learn easily. Parents who have an active, fit lifestyle are more likely to have kids who enjoy physical activity. And an active lifestyle is not only healthy, it's fun. Being active and playing helps everyone be strong and healthy. Play is for both kids and adults. The more you move, the better you feel. I'm going to tell you 10 ways play helps kids grow and helps adults feel great. Play helps build strong muscles. Using muscles is what makes them strong. Strong muscles help children run fast, play sports, dance, and climb. Having strong muscles helps us to sit up straight and keep our balance. Strong muscles also help prevent injuries. Play builds strong bones. When muscles grow stronger, bones do too. Exercise also strengthens the ligaments and tendons that support the bones. Strong tendons and ligaments are less likely to get injured. Exercise stimulates the release of the growth hormone that helps a child's muscles and bones grow stronger. Play builds a healthy heart. When you are moving, the heart has to work harder to pump blood and oxygen to the muscles. When the heart muscle works harder, it gets stronger. A stronger heart is able to pump more blood with each heartbeat, so it works better. The more you move, the more energy you will have. So to help you have a healthy heart, get moving. Play prevents you from getting sick. Moving arms, legs, and muscles, even during play, increase the number of white cells in the blood. These are the infection fighters that chase down germs and gobble them up. Running, playing, and moving muscles makes the army of germ fighters in your body grow stronger. Play keeps you lean. Running, jumping, playing, and walking all burn calories. Being physically fit also speeds up your metabolism so that you can burn more calories even when you're resting. Exercise turns the food you eat into firm, healthy muscle. Play improves coordination. Children become more coordinated as they mature. Older kids are better at catching and throwing than younger kids. Fun activities like running, swimming, skipping, playing sports, dancing, and climbing help our brains and bodies work better together. Play boosts mood. Exercise is as good for the mind as it is for the body. Teachers know that children return from recess in a better mood. Older kids and adults can concentrate better after a short walk. Moving or playing can calm you down if you are anxious and cheer you up if you are sad. Moving helps our bodies release hormones that help us feel good. Play curbs the appetite. The same hormones that boost your mood also control food cravings. When you find yourself wanting to eat a lot of sugary snacks like cookies, instead of going to the kitchen, go outside to play or just take a walk and get some fresh air. Play prevents tummy troubles. Both adults and children can suffer from constipation. Constipation can make you feel very uncomfortable. Playing and being active improves digestion and speeds the passage of food through the intestines. Moving our body helps move our bowels and allow the body to function and do all the normal things it needs to do. Play improves sleep. Lots of movement during the day will help you sleep better at night. Being active or playing at night may make it harder to fall asleep, so get as much playtime as possible during the day. Now I'm going to give you some good play tips. First, be a good example. The more active you are, the more active your family will be. Create good habits and the mindset that walking, working out, or playing together is simply what you do as a family. Get into a good exercise routine and others will follow your example. Also, enjoy play for two. Invite someone in your family or a friend to take a walk or jog with you. Share your workout or play catch. It can be really fun time together. And my third tip is play time before screen time. Make a rule that everyone in the family has to spend more time playing than sitting in front of a screen. For every minute you sit playing a video game or watching TV, you must also move for 1 minute in some type of physical activity. That means if you want an hour of screen time at the TV or computer, you can have it only after you have exercised or played outside for an hour. Active play is more important for everyone than television or computer time. Don't call it exercise. Instead of thinking of exercise as work, think about it as time together, moving, laughing, and having fun. Enjoy family play. Choose family hobbies and activities that require lots of movement, like hiking, biking, family walks, or games at the park. A family who plays together stays healthy together. Sign up for sports. Some adults and kids may not get enough exercise just by playing outside or working around the house. Sporting activities can help boost activity levels and improve coordination. Schedule active playtime. Invite friends over for fun and games. And the last tip, play while you watch. Jump rope, jumping jacks, jump on a mini trampoline, do sit-ups or anything like that while you watch TV. By making exercise and proper nutrition an important part of your life, you will find that family and friends will do the same. You can be a good example to them. Now, some important tips to help you prevent injuries during play. First, warm up. You should always warm up before playing a sport or actively playing. It is important to prepare your body for activity to prevent injuries. Also, increasing body temperature. Warming up increases your body temperature, heart rate, and breathing rate. It also increases blood flow to working muscles, which result in less muscle stiffness. And when you warm up your muscles, you're less likely to have injuries. The third tip is to start slow. A warm-up should include slow movements that are low intensity and then build up. Spending 5 to 10 minutes warming up is usually sufficient. Number 4, stretch your muscles. Stretching helps reduce the chance of injury and increases muscle flexibility. It is important not to hold your breath while stretching. Breathe slowly and easily. Number 5, stop and rest. It's a very important part of preventing injuries. Stop and rest when your muscles are tired. Studies show that athletes who don't get enough physical rest have more injuries. Many athletes think the more they train, the better they'll play, but this is not always true. Rest is critical and can prevent injuries caused by overuse, fatigue, and poor judgment. Recovery days reduce injury rates by giving muscles, ligaments, and tendons an opportunity to repair. Number 6, pain and fatigue are warning signs. Both children and adults should avoid playing sports or participating in strenuous physical activity when they are very tired or in pain. Pain indicates a problem. You need to pay attention to warning signs your body provides, or an injury is more likely. And the last tip, cool down. Cooling down helps reduce soreness and stiffness. Stretching after physical activity is good for flexibility and relaxing muscles. After playing a sport or participating in a strenuous physical activity, cool down by doing an easier activity such as easy jogging or walking, plus 5 minutes of gentle stretching. I hope you remember all the important things we learned about protein today, and I challenge you to get outside and play every day. Bye for now.